come to Murana?
Yes, sir.
It used to be infested with jacoids from the point of time.
Yes, sir.
Then you may want to tell me, you were able to qualify for the personality test 4 times in the past.
Yes, sir, including the forest.
Okay. What happened? Why you could not make it?
So actually, sir, it is a mix. In the marks in mains sometime in interview couldn't in aggregate they were not good.
How did you get in civil service PC?
So first time in 15 I got 95.
95?
Yes, sir. I did many mistakes that time.
You were speaking in English?
Yes, sir. In second time I got 132. In forest service 135. So this is the fourth.
95 means which board was it?
P.K. Joshi, sir.
P.K.?
Joshi, sir.
Achha.
Actually, that day almost leaving one person, everybody got around 110, 100, like this.
P.K. Joshi is the same person who is from Madhya Pradesh Public
Service
Commission?
Yes, sir.
You opted for mystery.
Yes, sir.
What is the use of chemistry in warfare? Say, chemical one.
Yes, sir. Sir, there are some chemicals which were used in the past in these war, like VX nerve agent and this mustard gas, so they were very deadly and causes irritation in the body, so it indirectly made the soldier.
Is chemical warfare legal?
Sir, nowadays according to the chemical weapon convention signed by other countries, so they prohibit the use of chemical weapons, so by that logic, it is illegal.
There was one gas used in the Vietnam War. What is the name of that gas?
Sir, I am not sure, but if you allow, I can take a guess. I think it was sarin gas.
Sarin?
Yes, sir.
Did America use it against?
Yes.
Do you know something about the fast track courts?
Sir, the fast track courts are established for a particular purpose, for the speedy justice.
For a particular purpose?
Purposes.
And the purpose is speedy justice.
Like, sir, fields may be decided, like some are financial sector or related to some, for example, maybe total male practices, we can establish a separate court, but the main purpose is for the speedy justice.
And who had recommended setting up of fast courts?
I'm sorry, sir, I'm not aware of that.
You know something about common civil court?
No, sir.
Okay, there are two words. One is competition, the other is rivalry. What is the difference between the two?
Competition, where two people are competing for achieving something, but they may not follow some. Sir, can I take a minute, sir? So, in competition, two people competing follow the rules, regulations, and compete for a position or a place in the market or any concerned areas, but a violent rivalry, they may not follow the rules, regulation in order to beat the opposite rivals.
They may not
follow the rules, okay. Regulation or...
So that means competition is better.
Yes, sir.
And rivalry is malicious.
Yes, sir.
Tell me something about yourself within a minute.
Sir, I am belong to Morena. I've done my education there. My family, my father is retired from Indian Army, and my mother is a homemaker. I have two siblings. Now I have come. I am a graduate from IIT Delhi, and I am currently working in EPFO.
EPFO,
Employee Provident
Fund. Sir, you have already working there.
Yes.
That was also on the basis of UPSC.
Yes.
And how much is your pay package?
Sir, that is 56,000 approx.
56,000?
Yes.
And the basic salary?
So basic is 48,000.
Are you able to manage? You are married, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Are you married or?
No, unmarried, sir.
Unmarried. So, are you able to manage your affairs? And family is there?
Yes, sir.
And you are still depending upon your parents?
No, no, sir. I am able to manage now.
Well, Anil Rathore, you are from Madhya Pradesh.
Yes, sir.
Madhya Pradesh was the first state to have brought capital punishment for against people who committed child rape.
Yes, sir.
So, was the state government constitutionally right to do that?
Sir, the state government has passed the bill, but it's made some amendment in IPC and constitution which needs to be approved by the center and president. So, if the president gave assent, then it become a constitution.
IPC, CRPC is in current list or concurrent list or state list?
Sir, they are in concurrent list.
Okay. You are from chemistry, your subject is chemistry.
Yes.
What is alchemy? Have you heard the word alchemy?
Archimedes.
Alchemy.
Sorry, sir, I will come across this.
Could they say now that alchemy basically is an ancient art of converting any metal into gold by, you know, using some chemical processes.
So I will learn about it.
Okay. Now, recently the new government in Madhya Pradesh, they waived farmers' loans.
Yes, sir.
Do you think it was a good step? Will it really help farmers?
Sir, according to my perception, it may help in the short run, but the government need not to resort such loan waivers on a policy basis.
Mm-hmm.
Because there may be need of the farmers at present, but overall we should take a holistic approach. In that, sir, loan waiver in my perception are not that good, because it create moral hazards.
Moral hazards?
Yes.
In what way?
It promotes a culture where people will not pay the bills from next time. Government will provide loan waiver again. So it will also injustice to the honest people who pay their loans timely.
But at the same time, it is the responsibility of the government, the state, to see that farmers who constitute almost 50-60% of the total population. They are the people who are working very hard to feed the rest of the country.
Yes, sir.
We must see to it that they are not under stress. They are able to live a dignified life. They don't have to run to a money lender and then mortgage their property, their everything, their women ornaments, and living a constant life, constant agony. what government should do and what exactly as a civil servant you would do to make sure that farmers, at least if they don't become rich, okay, but they are able to live a life where their basic needs are met.
So I agree to your opinion. I think the government need to take a long-term holistic approach, like implementing MS Swaminathan reports, recommendations. And
is it a long-term or is it a short-term or medium-term also?
Sir, the step need to be taken in every time, short-term step also and long-term step also. Immediate agony of the farmer also need to be removed. By and also in long-term, the they need to be made more skilled. We need to implement technology also in order to reduce their cost, such as the government introducing doubling the farmer income by 2022. It's a good initiative where we will reduce the cost to the farmer and increase their output or their income, such as bringing APMC reform at the market level, and while reducing cost by introducing scheme like soil health card and the recommendation of MS Swaminathan report. As a civil servant, sir, I will focus on the supply chain part of it, because the main thing according to me that is lacking is farmer are producing. For example, in my state, production is very good, but there is missing of supply chain. For example, there was a
basically marketing.
Yeah. Sir, recently I come across a case where in Madhya Pradesh farmers were getting only 8 rupees per kg for onion production, while in Andhra Pradesh there was people paying 60 rupees per kg. So there is huge mismatch of demand and supply. So if we can devise a mechanism through which the excess production can be resourced to the state where there is deficit, then we can balance.
Recently, Ministry of Agriculture has come out with agriculture export policy.
Yes.
Do you think it will help farmers?
So I think, sir, exporting the output will help them.
Who has brought this export policy? Ministry of Agriculture or?
Sir, I think Ministry of Agriculture. So by exporting, farmer will earn a foreign exchange. Also, the excess of production will be removed from the market. So there is a good balance of supply and demand, and I think price will increase in the market, then farmer will be benefited.
Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Export is there is a thing called allocation of business rules in the government of India. Every ministry has been given some business to be transact. So everything related to export import falls under the domain of Ministry of Commerce. Not agriculture. Okay. Anyway. Now tell me three tenets which are central to an effective civil servant. Three tenets, three characteristic features.
Which are first honesty, integrity, objectivity, and humility. I think that these are the three most important tenets of civil servant.
Are you confident that you possess these tenets?
Yes, sir. Right.
Can you give me an example from your college days, your IIT days, when you displayed your honesty?
Sir,
any one example, one real time, real life experience.
Sir, in my school day, once I did some cheating and I was not caught, but from my internal side, I was not feeling very good, so I went to the teacher and told her that I did this mistake, please cut my marks, and that was the incident where I think I showed some courage.
You found it a good strategy? After that you felt relieved?
Sir, after that I feel relieved, and definitely, sir.
So then you realize that honesty is the best policy.
Yes, sir. It also, sir, encouraged me to always be prepared to not indulge in such things. So it has other benefit also.
Right. what is a civil society?
So yes, civil society is basically where the rule of law is followed, and the government treats all the people equally, and so here the citizens have voice, freedom of speech and expression.
That's it. Don't matter. Tell me, what is drip irrigation?
So in drip irrigation, we use the water is not applied in bulk, but in its form of small droplets. So where the water is absorbed very, very good by the sand of that soil, and there is no erosion of soil because of it. So the fertility of soil remains very good.
And what is UNICEF?
Sorry sir, I forgot the full name.
No problem. In case there is a aircraft crash.
Yes.
Tell me blow by blow account of what you are going to do as a civil servant.
Sir, an aircraft has already crashed.
Yes. Somewhere in the hilly region.
Yes, sir.
What are you going to do?
Sir, my first step will be to send the relief there immediately, and if and try to find out if there is any single person, if he is still alive, then try to save the life first. Through, and then second is to secure the perimeter and to set up a task force to check what is was the reason for such crash. Such crash, and the report should be holistic, in comprising of all the details, and for the immediate, and also for the future purposes, and so the compensation that need to be given to the families of the affected immediately, based on the reports.
You mean to say you send the not the relief, you send the rescue?
Yes, a rescue
and
relief.
And pick up whatever evidence you get.
And first try to save the lives, if anybody is alive.
The rescue team will do it. They'll airlift from which those guys who are stranded. And then you'll call for an inquiry.
Yes, sir.
Now, when you're actually collecting evidences,
yes,
what evidence are you looking for when there is a plane crash?
Sir, there is one thing I have heard about, black box. It contains some crucial information that cockpit that happens in the cockpit, and very informative instrument it is. And apart from it, like some information such as is there failure of instrument or the error was due to the personal negligence of the people which is flying the aircraft, and so whether the weather conditions are
what black box is black in color.
Sorry sir, I have not seen it, but I've just heard about it.
But what do you think? It should be black because it's called black box, right?
Yes.
Okay. Suppose in case you are IPS officer, what do you think is morbocracy now rampant in India?
So morbocracy is an act where people took law and order in their own hand for the faster delivery of justice, as they think and leading to the violation of human rights of the other person, which is the victim.
If you are a very senior cop,
yes, sir,
and you are called by the Prime Minister,
yes,
to form a team and snoop on an opposition leader, what will be your take on this kind of thing?
Sir, I will explain him that it is violative of freedom of speech and expression, and there is no threat. If there is no threat of law and order, so I will tell him that I will not do it.
He's asking you to get him information on some opposition leaders, and you tell him that there is no threat to him.
Sir, it is a violation of constitution, so I will not take up such job, and I will reject such job.
Very nice, displays of sincerity. But do you think it happens in the real world?
I think, sir, it also happens in the real world. They are very honest officers in our system. But these things may not come in the public because of discipline and other matters.
Okay. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
So, your father is in the army.
Yes, sir.
Do you think that the sahayak or a buddy is required for that training servant and army personnel?
Sir, sahayak system has its advantage and disadvantage. Actually, it was introduced as a concept in the areas like Siachen or far off area where captain which is involved in war or very serious thinking, he gets the free time. So there I think it has some relevance today also. But the areas such as plain area where there is such as called peaceful area in army terms, there is no need of such sahayak system. There we can remove it, sir.
Yesterday that bad beating retreat was celebrated. Why is beating retreat has been celebrated since means every year?
Sorry sir, I don't know.
You are passed out from the Emmanuel High School.
Yes,
who is Immanuel Kant and what is that philosophy of transcendental idealism?
Sorry sir, I don't know.
You have, right now you are working for the EPFO.
Yes sir.
Now government has decided to hike a minimum pension of rupees 2000.
Yes sir.
Do you think that it is a gift, means like a burden on the government, increase the pension of that all the pensioners?
Sir, it will definitely increase the fiscal deficit and government expenditure because the government will now pay the more pension. So I think, sir, it will increase government expenditure.
How much burden of the government in the terms of rupees for the pension they are giving to that all pensioners?
Sir, I am not sure about this. If you allow, I can take a guess. It's around 6 to 7 thousand crore rupees.
You have written about the student mentor in IIT Delhi.
Yes.
How can you mentor the students?
Sir, during our first year, but actually I also felt the need of counselor because I came from a rural background. I don't know about many things that took place in the IITs and in the college itself. So I was a bit nervous by seeing such environment. So at that time, I feel my mentor provided me a very good support, and he explained me what are the areas, and in order to balance both studies and sport and other cultural activities. So from there, I get a sense that I should also be helpful and try to guide the people who need my help. So as a mentor, I have been able to guide my mentors in order to balance their physical activities, sports and studies.
Okay. passed the 12th class in 2010.
Yes.
And finally B.Tech from 2015.
Yes.
So it will take around 5 years to complete this course.
No, sir. In 2011, I took a break for preparing for the IIT.
You have written about your hobby, this charcoal drawing.
Ah, yes, sir.
How can you get the charcoal?
Sir, charcoal, it's available in the market, but it's manufactured by the combustion of wood in the absence of oxygen, anaerobic decomposition.
So what are the drawing you are, means, how can you draw that? What are kind of drawing you are doing?
Sir, I generally used to draw still life sketch where the objects are generally stationary, not moving.
So it is on the ground or on the paper or
there? Sir, it's on the paper.
It's on the paper. You have also played in an inter-hostel cricket tournament. What is DRS system in cricket?
Sir, DRS system is a decision review system where the if a player or a team is thinking that umpire made a wrong decision, they can review the decision by the umpire.
And can this decision have been adopted by the BCCI?
Sir, yes sir.
Sure.
So now Indian teams when go to play outside, they...
And inside India?
Sorry sir, I am not aware about it.
What is the field position, tilly point and forward short leg in cricket?
Sir, like silly points, sir, the say, sorry, sir, I'm not able to.
Forward short leg?
Sir, there are like square, forward square, and forward short leg
is on the left side or on the off side?
Leg side, sir.
And it is close to that batsman?
Sir, it's close to that umpire.
Umpire. Thank you.
Anil?
Yes.
I think you need to prepare a lot.
Yes.
Both in terms of knowledge as well as articulation.
Yes.
I am not able to understand that why you did not opt for Hindi? You are from rural background.
Yes, sir.
You should have asked for Hindi as a medium of answering in PT.
So actually, I'm not that, like, I'm made of both, sir. Neither no English too good, neither Hindi too good.
But how can that be? Where did you study here? You studied in Hindi?
Yes, sir. Like, medium was English, but English was not spoken there. Sir, actually I was confused with, basically, how can I know the Hindi words if I forget? I can...
If you don't know Hindi, you use the English word?
So, like, in actual interview, we can use Hindi and English
words? Yes, in technical, particularly in technical matter.
But when you are given choice that you will be taking into English, then use of Hindi words will not be taken kindly. You may use once a while, but no more than that.
Okay, sir.
You have to, the interview will be in English, they will be asking in English, you have to reply in English. At the most, one or two words you can use in English. You can't cure mix. But for the interviewer, the number of words of English can be more. I mean, generally spoken words can be used. You can't speak English sentences, of course, but you can speak English words when you go for Hindi interview, but not the vice versa. When you are taking English interview, it will be in English.
Come on.
Say 11th March.
You start talking to your friends, your peers, not say in English. You put your own study, you put your own study, you speak.
So it can be improved, or I think I
no,
can
no, offer it can be improved, yes, why not?
See, practice can always...
It's like actually technical question will be difficult to answer in Hindi.
I'll tell you. Sir, you see, interview, you basically cover 6-7 aspects. One is your DAF.
Yes, sir.
DAF includes your state, your educational background, you are optional in the civil services, your home. These are the 4-5 areas. So you list out all the possible questions and start working on those. From your state, from your country, what are the possible questions? So that everything should be ready-made in your mind. And you should analyze the language of the question and immediately formulate the reply accordingly and you can give.
Yes.
So that is one. Second, your current affairs. Current affairs unlimited. Current affairs, they can ask anything. So for that, you have at least there are some certain topics which are really appearing in newspaper almost on a daily basis. Triple talaq, Sabarimala, Supreme Court judgments on privacy, etc. And your international, we didn't ask you any question on international relations. China, Pak, Afghanistan, all these RCEP, right? There are so many things happening. So you should list one by one and write in 3-4 lines what is the main issue.
So basically crisp answers.
Crisp answer, but at the same time, you should be able to articulate. Because if you say, I ask question on elections. So election, there are 100 type of questions can be asked. So you can't memorize everything.
Yes, sir.
That is, it is not that, but if you have the overall knowledge, you have a framework of reply. So then quickly, the moment I ask, your mind is work much faster than computer. It can fill out information. And accordingly you articulate and try to speak less, because your clarity would be because of your language problem. Clarity would come only when you speak less. So that is one. Of course it will take time to improve, but still you have more than 1 month. So I'm sure if you work on these things, make and then read newspaper loudly every at least 3-4 hours every day, Hindu, so that important keywords you can pronounce properly.
Yes.
The sentencing can and pause in between. जैसे अखबार में आप पढ़ेंगे ना, तो अखबार में जैसे दिया हुआ एक सेंटेंस उतना पढ़िए, फुल स्टॉप पे रुकिए, जस्ट वन और वन सेकंड, नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस, वो उस तरह की हैबिट डेवलप कीजिए आप. तो स्पीकिंग इज वन. देन कॉन्फिडेंस, ऑफ कोर्स आई फाउंड लैक ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस ऑल्सो, दैट विल ऑल्सो कम थ्रू स्पीकिंग. वंस यू स्टार्ट स्पीकिंग प्रॉपरली, then I'm sure your confidence level will also rise. Sir.
The एक bluffing मत करिए थी board को. अगर आपको नहीं आता answer, sir say I'm sorry sir. आप कहते हैं कि sir I'm not very sure but I will make an attempt. Then आप next sentence sir I'm sorry I didn't know. अगर आपको नहीं आता तो नहीं आता. जिसने जो भी कुछ पूछा हो सकता है उसमें से कुछ भी ना पूछे वो, तो ऐसे क्वेश्चन पूछे जो आपने इमेजिन नहीं किए होंगे, तो उसमें ब्लफिंग मत करिए. उनको नहीं आता है. और उन्होंने पूछा था सिविल सोसाइटी, इसका आंसर भी बड़ा ठीक नहीं था, बिल्कुल गलत भी था. व्हाट इज अ सिविल सोसाइटी, आप डिफाइन कर सकते हैं सिविल सोसाइटी में कौन कौन लोग हैं? Who all constitute civil society? पढ़ लीजिए आप. That's what he was referring to.
Yes, sir.
और उसमें जैसे बोलिए क्या था? Erosion of soil keep its fertility. आपने किया?
अरे drip irrigation.
That was totally wrong answer.
ये बिल्कुल absolutely गलत
answer. सुन.
देखिए जब इरोजन ऑफ सॉइल होती है तो रिवाइंस बन जाती है. रिवाइंस बंजर पड़ी हुई है अभी तक, आप कितने हजारों सालों से पड़ी हुई है, अभी तक एक पत्ता भी नहीं है वहां उसका. तो आपने कैसे मान लिया कि इट विल मेक दी
सर? आई वाज सेइंग लाइक ड्रिप इरिगेशन प्रिवेंट सॉइल इरोजन.
लेकिन कह गए आप कुछ और ना.
क्या कुछ हो गया
था? एक्चुअली I was like comparing between the two. If there is no drip irrigation,
clarity should be there.
Clarity, because you have already one thing, you should be clear that you have cleared it twice.
Yes.
Right, you have cleared IFS also. That means your ability to write exam is unquestionable. You are very good at that. Now, only thing you need to improve about your personality. focus will be on that and read at least 6-7 hours a day, all the current affairs, civil society, general terms. Now everything on Google, you can go to the laptop, you see, you can see everything. See your real literature.
I think like I haven't mentioned EPFO in this because I filled the dev before joining it. So should I
mention? You must mention. You mentioned that after filling up your drive, when did you join? Say for example, interview board asked me what are you doing it.
Yes.
You say that I have joined EPFO in this and this month. So automatically they will understand that at the time of filling up of you are not in that position. Don't hide anything. Be very truthful, be honest. And but again, as Chairman sir has mentioned, you need huge preparation,
Sir, actually I got nervous 2 times.
Smile kijiye aur nervousness, jab aapko pata hai ki meri ye problem hai. Once you identify your problem, that nervousness is your problem, then you work on that.
I should prepare answer because that will
yeah, be... you make classify, I told you the interview will be on these. Make all possible questions, think on those, then articulate in your mind, if this is how I will reply like this. But be brief. Again, language is not your strength. So mind it. Be, if you speak less, you will speak less, you will commit more, less mistakes. That is the thing.
Actually, when I think in my mind, I think I can make the answer clear, but when I speak, there is mismatch.
Thought जो है ना आपका वो हिंदी में सोचता है, तो क्या आपकी मातृभाषा हिंदी है? मतलब हिंदी बोलते हैं और क्या बोलते हैं?
हिंदी.
हाँ, तो जो आप thought process है उसकी language हिंदी है. हम सबके साथ ही ऐसा है, हम भी हिंदी के लिए और हम उसको translate करते हैं English में. लेकिन हमारे में हो सकता है कुछ थोड़ी ज्यादा हो capability की हम उसको immediately translate करें, और अब हमने सोचना भी English में शुरू कर दिया है. आपको आप हिंदी में ही सोचते हैं फिर उसमें अटक जाते हैं कॉन्वर्सेशन में. दैट्स व्हाई योर इंग्लिश स्पीकिंग इज वेरी पुअर.
रीड न्यूज़पेपर लाउडली, मिनिमम 2-3 आवर्स, एवरी डे विदाउट फेल.
यस,
मॉड्यूलेटिंग विद मॉड्यूलेटिंग वॉइस. लिसन टू यूट्यूब, हाउ पर्टिकुलर वर्ड्स आर प्रोनाउंस्ड, देयर आर वेरी डाउट. एवरीथिंग इज अवेलेबल ऑन यूट्यूब एंड गूगल एक्सेट्रा. The entire world is at your fingertips. Okay.
Hard work.
Yes, sir.
Only hard work for this 1 month, and I'm sure you'll be able to overcome your problems.
Yes.
Otherwise, you are a pleasant personality. Only these are few attributes of a civil servant. Because after all, you understand one basic thing, Anil, that after your selection, huge responsibilities will be given as a civil servant.
Yes, sir.
So the interview board is having a huge task of selecting people who can handle that responsibility. Because after once you are IAS, then nobody will come to your rescue. You are district magistrate, you have to handle on your own.
Yes, sir.
Try to understand that. Every situation you have to handle on your own, and for that you require a huge amount of confidence, huge amount of articulation. You will have to chair the meetings, your entire district official will be in front of you. So you have to, right now, start thinking like a civil servant. Okay?
Yes.
बाकी सारे members ने कह दिया है, तो अभी आपका 1 महीने का time आपके पास है.
40 days.
आपके पास experience भी है interview में appear होने का. Already आप service में हैं. तो आपके पास लूज करने का कुछ नहीं है, जो भी मिलेगा वो आप गेन करेंगे. सबसे पहला चीज आपको करना क्या है, सर ने भी जैसा बताया, क्योंकि आप हिंदी से हैं, वर्ड फ्रीक्वेंटली आपके मुंह पे आ जाएगा. यू नीड टू रीड दैट न्यूज पेपर, वॉट एवर इन फ्रंट ऑफ मिरर एंड ऑल. सपोज इफ यू आर एनी फ्रेंड हु इज गिविंग इंटरव्यू, और मे बी एनी वन हु इज जिनके साथ आप रहते हैं, एवरी डे इन द इवनिंग यू गिव 10-20 क्वेश्चन, दे विल आस्क यू फ्रॉम यू, और मे बी आफ्टर दैट यू कैन ट्राई टू गिव द आंसर. एंड यू हैव अ स्मार्टफोन, आप अपना रिकॉर्ड ऑन करिए, देखिए उसको, और हर दिन देखिए कि आपके उसमें क्या क्या दिक्कतें आ रही हैं. एवरी डे देन यू कैन इम्प्रूव योर सेल्फ, अदरवाइज देर इज नो ऑप्शन शॉर्टकट मेथड कि आप उसमें इम्प्रूव कर सकते हैं. पहला. दूसरा जो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज है, यू नीड टू एनालाइज योर डैफ एनालिटिकली. अभी मैंने आपसे क्वेश्चन किया मतलब ईपीएफओ के ऊपर में, आपको ये नहीं पता कि सरकार कितना पेंशन दे रही है जब आप उसी डिपार्टमेंट में काम कर रहे हैं। जैसे आप ये नाम लेंगे कि मैं आई एम वर्किंग विद दैट ईपीएफओ वट एवर द मीन्स लाइक पोस्ट, देन दे विल सर्टेनली आस्क यू क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दैट एंगल। आई हैव आस्क्ड अबाउट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द क्रिकेट, आई हैव आस्क्ड अबाउट द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम मेंटरिंग ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स, तो कहीं भी क्वेश्चन का कन्विंसिंग आंसर मुझे नहीं लगा, जबकि आपके वर्ड उसमें डैप में ये वर्ड सारे लिखे गए। तो एटलीस्ट 150-200 क्वेश्चन आप प्रिपेयर कर लीजिए पहले डैप के ऊपर, जो कि आपका डोमेन एरिया जहां से आप क्वेश्चन एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हो। जो लास्ट वाला जो सर बार बार बोलते हैं उसमें कि करंट अफेयर्स जो कि अनलिमिटेड है, कुछ भी पूछा जा सकता है, वो तो ऐसे भी अनप्रेडिक्टेबल है, आप पता नहीं कर सकते क्या पूछना। जो प्रेडिक्टेबल लाइन पे क्वेश्चन आ सकता है उसका जवाब तो सही से दे दीजिए।
और क्रिकेट के बारे में पूछा क्रिकेट का, तो अब वो आपको अगर बिकॉज यू आर प्लेइंग क्रिकेट एंड इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू
इवन फील्ड पोजीशन इज अ सिंपल वन, मतलब आप कहीं भी जानते हैं। डीआरएस में भी मैंने आपको प्रोवोक किया कि वो करता या नहीं करता, आप तुरंत में हाथ सरेंडर कर गए। आपको वो कॉन्फिडेंस होना चाहिए कि हाँ इंडियन टीम उसको अडॉप्ट किया या बीसीसीआई किया या नहीं किया, क्लैरिटी ऑफ थॉट्स इन योर माइंड,
मतलब ये वेरी फ्रैंक ओपिनियन वी हैव गिवन, वेरी फ्रैंक,
दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एक्चुअली।
यू शुड एंड आई विल बी वेरी हैप्पी टू सी यू इन, वेरी हैप्पी, बिकॉज देयर आर सर्टेन थिंग्स व्हिच जस्ट फॉर मे बी बिकॉज ऑफ आवर अपब्रिंगिंग, आवर सोशल बैकग्राउंड, वी आर नॉट अप टू द मार्क, वी आर मच स्ट्रॉन्गर देन अदर्स, we are much stronger than others in our in integrity, in our character, but because of our poor geographical location, suppose you are born and brought up in a rural area, so you can't, the language barrier that is in Hindi also, your confidence etc., all these problems are there. So I don't want you to suffer because of this, despite the fact that you are intelligent guy, hard working IIT product. So I personally feel I would like to see you in, okay.